Good morning students. In the last two classes we have studied the noise in double sideband with suppressed carrier and noise in single sideband with suppressed carrier. In today's lecture we will study double sideband with full carrier, that is double sideband with a carrier accompanied with it. That also called double sideband with carrier DSB-FC or DSB-C, or that is also called full AM. Let us discuss that. As I have told you that the block diagram remains same for double sideband suppressed carrier, single sideband suppressed carrier and double sideband with carrier. The change here is the input power at the input power. Here in the double sideband only two sidebands come. In the single sideband suppressed carrier only upper sideband or lower sideband comes, but in the double sideband with full carrier, or double sideband, that is also for double sideband DSB-C, double sideband with carrier also, that is called full AM. In that case here the input signal is two sidebands along with the carrier, but that do not hamper the output signal power because that carrier is filtered out in the carrier filter, because you know that the carrier filter has the frequency range FC minus FM to FC plus FM or minus FC plus FM to minus FC minus FM. So the output, the FC got cancelled out. Only the when you take the upper sideband, we will take this one FC to FC plus FM. Similarly, if you take the upper sideband here, minus FC to minus FC minus FM. So the FC part cancels out. So the carrier is not passed. So the output remains same. So we can use the same equation of double sideband suppressed carrier in case of finding the signal to noise ratio. So we'll start with the equation that the same double sideband with suppressed carrier, that is S0 by N0 equal to SI by eta FM. If you try to recall your double sideband suppressed carrier, this is the equation. Here instead of SI we take SI SB, that means SI with sidebands, because the carrier is filtered out, only we consider the two sidebands. So this is the equation 1. I am writing that SI of SB equal to power in sideband alone. It means we will consider the only sidebands. Now consider the equation of DSB with full carrier. You have studied in the your full AM case, AM class. In the full AM, the equation is SI of T equal to A into 1 plus M of T cos 2 pi FCT, where M of T is the modulating signal. So if you expand this one, this becomes SI of T equal to A cos 2 pi FCT plus A M of T into cos 2 pi FCT. Give this equation 2. Now let us calculate the power. The power of the carrier is, this is the carrier part. Its power is A square by 2. Now the power of, this is the sideband. The sideband power is, we denote this as A square M square T bar by 2. What is that? This M square by T is the this m square by t bar is the time average of square of modulating signal. So this you can treat this as the amplitude. So a square by 2, that means a square m square of t average by 2. So m square of t is the time average means the bar, the time average of square of the modulating signal. Square of the modulating signal is m square of t and by 2. Now we'll calculate the total power. The total power is SI. We denote the signal as SI of t, but the power we take this SI, there is no bracket t. So SI is total power is a square by 2 plus a square m square of t average by 2. If you take, let us give this equation 3. Now if you take common a square by 2, then we have 1 plus m square t. Give this equation. So SI equal to a square by 2 1 plus m square of t average. This is equation 4. But your sideband power, out of this, which one is the sideband? This is the sideband. This is the carrier power. This is the sideband power. So sideband power is, this is the sideband power. A square m square t average by 2. Give this equation 5. Now dividing equation 5 by 4. Now we'll divide equation 5 by 4. This is 5. This is the equation 5 by 4. 4 is this one. Now this is 5. This is 4. Now divide 5 by 4. You divide, it gives. So dividing equation 5 by 4, a square cancels, 2 2 cancels. So sideband by SI equal to m square of t average by 1 plus m square of t. So this is equation 6. Now you multiply this. If you multiply this one, SI is multiplied here. Now we denote this as equation 6. Now go back to your equation 1. Now you can see from equation 1, the signal to noise ratio equal to SI of sideband by eta FM. So now putting equation 6 in equation 1, that is S0 by N0 equal to, the equation 1 is S0 by N0 equal to SI SP by eta FM. So SI value is this one, SI into m square of t average by 1 plus m square of t average into 1 by eta FM. Now you can rearrange the equation, S0 by N0 equal to m square of t average by 1 plus m square of t average into SI by eta FM. So give this equation 7. Now we can also calculate this signal to noise ratio in terms of carrier power. What is the carrier power? If you remember the equation 4, from equation 4, SI equal to a square by 2 in 1 plus m square of t bar. So can I replace this equation 4 here? Can I replace this SI from equation 4? So S0 by N0 equal to m square of t. So putting equation 4 here. 1 plus m square of t average into SI is a square by 2 into 1 plus m square of t average by 2. This is SI. y type m. Now this 1 plus m square of t and this 1 plus m square of t cancels. So the remaining portions are we'll take another paper. S0 by N0 equal to m square of t average into a square by 2 by eta fm. This is nothing but the carrier power. So S0 by N0, we know that carrier power is a square by 2. So m square of t, thus carrier power I am denoting as bc by eta fm. So you can write the signal to noise ratio in terms of carrier power. This is one way of writing equation 8. Now if your modulating signal is sinusoidal, let us say m of t equal to m into cos 2 pi fm t, then what is the case? So in this case, if m of t is m cos of cos 2 pi fm t, then m square of t average is its amplitude square by 2. Let us give this equation 9. Now your equation 7 becomes equation 7 is S0 by N0 equal to m square of t average by 1 plus m square of t average into SI by eta fm. This is equation 7. Now this m square of t equal to m square by 2. Now we replace this one. S0 by N0 equal to, this is, we have put m square by 2 plus m square by 2 into SI by eta fm, right? So if you take the LCM and cancels out, this is m square by, this 2 cancels, m square by 2 plus m square SI by eta fm, right? S0 by N0 equal to this one. So this is equation number 10. Now if you recall the figure of merit, this is called S0 by N0 equal to m square by 2 plus m square into, this is SI by NM, signal to noise ratio at the output. This is the signal to noise ratio at the input. NM is the noise at the input. Now if you divide this one by this one, that is S0 by N0 by SI by NM, it becomes S0 by N0 by SI by NM equal to m square by 2m square, m square by 2 plus m square. This is equation 12. This is called figure of merit, as we have derived for double sideband suppressed carrier and single sideband suppressed carrier. The gamma was, the figure of merit gamma was 1 in that case. In that two cases gamma was 1, but here the gamma is m square by 2 plus m square. This is for sinusoidal case, but in general from the equation 7, S0 by N0 equal to m square of t average by 1 plus m square of t average into SI by eta fm. This is S0 by N0 by m square t average by 1 plus m square t average. This is SI by NM. So if you divide that, the figure of merit gamma equal to S0 by N0 by SI by NM, that is equal to m square of t average by 1 plus m square of t average. So figure of merit gamma in general is m square of t average by 1 plus m square of t average. So from equation 13 and 14, for double sideband with full carrier, that is full AM, the figure of merit gamma equal to m square by 2 plus m square for sinusoidal signal, for sinusoidal baseband signal. for any signal, in general signal, not specific to sinusoidal, the figure of merit, the figure of merit gamma equal to m square of t average by 1 plus m square of t average. This is equation 14. So thank you.